Alright, hopefully the static, if there's any, clears up. You know, normally I start a little 5 minutes after for EST, but had some stuff to do, so I had to get those things done. I don't know if I'll have to get up at any point, but this is my official starting time. Time to finish this game. I'm on chapter 6, the last chapter. Let's try and help Alan save his wife.
Sunglasses made the world look bearable. Now I could keep my eyes open without feeling like a vampire in the sun. The pills worked fast. The prospect of being awake started to seem bearable again. There was a message waiting for me on the machine.
Right, I'm just gonna check out the house, see if there are any collectibles before I answer the message. That triggers off the next part of the game. So this is where Spider-Man lives. New York, New York. Alright, time to answer this message. Oh. Alright, so here there's some static on the stream. I don't know where the static is going. Oh, it's back again. And it's gone. I just.
Talk about my latest book. The show is.
I'm just waiting for the static to clear up this one. I don't know what's causing that exactly. I don't hear it all the time. Usually adjusting the mic. Alright, I think it still here or not. I don't know if it's, let me move the fan a bit. I doubt it's the fan because here it would sound different. Alright, sounds clear enough, so I'll just continue playing. And then back to my stream. Alright, I'm gonna see if I move. Testing some stuff here. Yeah, I'm still hearing it. I know it's gone for some reason. Okay, so I'll just keep playing now. Hopefully it's good. And where's the remote?
haven't read the book yet. Based on the sales figures, the two people out there who haven't read the book yet. But this last book is all about the death of the main character, the hard-boiled New York detective, Alex Casey. Now, there's been a lot of outrage about this. Why the hell did you kill Casey? What the hell were you thinking, man?
Good riddance. No, seriously, though. 7 years and six books is a long time. He was a gloomy guy to spend all your working hours with, and it was a good run. But it's time to explore new things. The next book will be a departure from the old for me.
You selfish bastard, always thinking of yourself. Well, you've certainly given us a lot of entertainment over the years. And now that you mention it, Casey was a gloomy guy. Never had much luck with his love life, the lady. Was that autobiographical in any way?
Yeah, no kidding. Casey's lady friends tended to die on him. With Casey, it was all about his pain. No, nothing autobiographical about that. I'm a happily married man. My wife is my muse.
Well, congratulations. That's great to hear. So, how's the publicity tour been treating you?
Good. Great. But I gotta say, I'm glad to be back home in New York.
Boy, you've certainly been on the news a lot lately. Lots of parties and, you got into a fight with some paparazzi.
Oh, man. Well, that guy was really in my face. I lost my temper. I know that wasn't cool.
You are famous for that temper.
Well, I did also write several books.
Well, your latest novel is called The Sudden Stop, and it's in bookstores now. Go get it. That means the two of you out there having fun. Ladies and gentlemen, that's all we have for you tonight. I want to thank all our guests for the evening, Alan Wake, Sam Lake. Once more, do the face for the Sam. And our musical guests, Poets of the Fall. Thank you.
At least I've been funny. I told myself I could live with that.
Did you watch the show?
I didn't say anything stupid, if that's what you want to know.
Okay, Grumpy. You want an aspirin or something?
Are you going to start with me about drinking now?
You know what?
I should have followed her advice. But suddenly I would...
What? Now you can't even talk to me?
Well, this morning I was angry because you said you'd be home at midnight and you showed up at 7 a.m. and passed out in mid-sentence. Now I'm over it. Are you angry?
This goddamn tour. It's gotten out of hand.
Oh, honey. It's almost over, right? We can get back to normal and we can start writing again.
I'm sorry, honey.
Alan, you're not thinking straight. Just take a shower and go back to bed, huh?
Yeah. You're right, honey. I'm sorry. Once this is over, let's go away together. A vacation. Just you and me. Some peace and quiet.
Bright Falls, the present day.
Somehow, the clicker was the key to the cabin. I had to return to Cauldron Lake to save Alice.
I'm thinking it might only work when you're
going back to the lake to finish this.
When he goes
I'm
in the
going
lake.
To write an ending to the story in the manuscript on my own terms to make it all right.
Why can't you just write it here?
The last page is still in the typewriter. I need to read it first. Everything needs to be just right. Zane tried to cut some corners, and it didn't end well.
Okay, ready when you are.
I'm sorry, Sarah, but I need to do this alone.
Wait, why?
Mary, take her gun.
Why you had to do that?
Miss Weaver, close the door when I leave.
Why did I take her gun, though? You don't need to take her gun. I mean, she already believes that, you know, you are the key to the whole thing.
See you later.
Unless...
When I got out, it was warm and sunny. I'd flicked the switch of the clicker. Had it done this? I didn't stop to question it. I had to take advantage of the sunlight to get to the lake. On Zane's page, I'd stood on the rim of Cauldron Lake, about to use the clicker. That's where I was headed.
Can I drive there, or are we gonna cut straight to that point?
Alone, in
daylight, surrounded by the beauty of the Pacific Northwest landscape. It was hard not to let doubt creep in one last time. I could still chalk everything up to a dream, a delusion. I had enough imagination to make up something like this, having been in the cabin all this time, trapped in a story inside my head, gone mad from grief over Alice's death like Hartman had claimed. There would be no way of knowing. I told myself it didn't really matter. My course was set.
I can't take the gun out. I was trying to shoot the can, the beer cans. Maybe it's not something you need to shoot. Alright, look, they're letting us drive. Visit the haunted witch's ladle. Where is it? Cauldron Lake Campgrounds. Your home in the pines. Hopefully it doesn't turn nighttime on me. It's already looking a bit hazy. Probably the most relaxing part of the game is this one. I wonder why I'd have two cars. I'm gonna switch to the other car. Ooh. So basically, if you don't veer off the straight pathway, you'll be going there with just one pistol and nothing else. So chances are maybe I missed some weapons further up the road, and they parked another car just in case the one I was driving got damaged, or it could just be random car placement. It's actually getting darker. I am probably wasting. Oh no. I've been wasting time. I thought it would stay like bright forever. Oh no. I made a mistake.
There was a link between us, always would be. I could feel its presence again, getting closer.
wasted time. I mean, technically I didn't waste any time. I was using my time.
The Dark Presence was no longer trying to capture the writer so he could create the ending it wanted. The writer knew too much. He was too strong. And he carried a weapon left behind by Thomas Zane, something that could hurt it. Now, the darkness was doing everything in its power to simply stop the writer from ever reaching Cauldron Lake and the dark place it came from.
And it looks like there are only a few pages for this section. Oh yeah, great. I think I probably shouldn't stop at this point. I'm probably gonna be under attack. So I should probably not. Not take a casual stroll looking for things. What's up there? Curiosity killed the cat. Meow.
Based on the signature in the motel register, Agent Nightingale had stayed here in room number 2.
Oh, we could find out. Probably find out what it is he, hold on to switch to shotgun. How much shots does it have? Ooh, 2? 6? Rifle had how much? 8? 8 versus 6. Okay, rifle it is. So if you find Nightingale's room, wait, which room it was? Room number 2? Ooh.
This had obviously been the room where Agent Nightingale had stayed when he hadn't been busy harassing me.
Huh. He's been surveilling people. So let me make sure I check every nook and cranny. Even the sheriff. I wish there was more though. More information. Like exactly what he knew. Why is this place so big? It's like begging me to search it out. Okay, but I don't think I wanna like really switch out every nook and cranny of this place because I'm really supposed to be going somewhere. And this thing is actually trying to kill me, so I don't want to be stuck out here for too long. Looks like I'm out of why is this car moving? This looks like a death trap. Like everything is gonna just come alive. Yeah, I was literally trying to just close the doors. Thank you. things happen in a different way the next time around. Wow. I guess basically this whole section is like, just move, don't stay. Cause if you stay, you die. Wait, can I? You probably can't hop over this railing. Okay, let's go. Could you move? Okay. Maybe I could have run past them, I didn't try. So I think I'll try one more run past thing, segment. Actually, I don't need to do the run past, I could just like, see, blast them. Okay, I'm gonna try to run past. Okay. Yeah, okay. I think you literally have to fight them. Alrighty. Let's fight. I'll go section by section. I mean, that's what I was doing before, but I don't know. And I'll let my flashlight recharge and then continue. I feel like I'm out of the woods because that was a pretty big enemy. Oh, great. Have to avoid hit it. Oh, what? They really don't want me driving through here. Alright. Let me just see if there's any little thing I can collect. Bullets, preferably. See some enemies still there coming up. Yep, they're still coming. Adios, muchachos. Hey, stuff right here, right in the light. See, so right now I'm 7 on the rifle. How much on the pump action? 16! Oh gosh, this crap. I probably don't even need to remove them, but why not, you know? Gotta move. Where do these guys even come from? Oh.
bottom of Cauldron Lake was a graveyard of things the lake had claimed in one way or another over the decades. The Dark Presence brought them up in its wake, scattering the rotten waterlogged hull of an old boat here, the remains of a long-ago crashed airplane there, trees shattered under the impacts, the earth groaned, and didn't even notice.
Just taking out a drink, some peanut punch. Ah yes, the beautiful paper straw. Everybody loves it. It's so great. Alright, just gonna try and get a little bit of this drink here, and then I'll continue. All this running has made me dehydrated. Ugh. Can't even breathe. The minute you think about exploring. Hey, what's that? My spidey senses are tingling. I guess nothing. Maybe. Maybe not. Alright, nothing to see here. Excuse me. How far is Cauldron Lake? Is there like a map I could check? Just a minute. You need to take another sip. I would turn up the mic, but because I've been having so much trouble with it lately, I'll just leave it down. So just a little bit of peanut punch drinking ASMR. And the thing is, because my room is so warm, like my whatever I have in the room slowly becomes room temperature. So you see, all visitors must see yard manager. Have I been here before? Ooh, come on. Man, I just wanna breathe, man. Collect ammo and breathe. If this was a game that I didn't really care too much for, I would be speeding through all the levels, only doing what was absolutely necessary. Make sure this everything is reloaded. I think you need to do 5 of those to get a trophy. So, or some kind of achievement. There's probably something in the back, you know, but do I want to go in the back there? See, how's my revolver looking? Revolver 31. I could get some more rounds. Ooh, is there a TV show in here? Nope. Okay, let me just check at the back, and it looks like I was right. There is something. I do sense trouble too. I did dodge. Okay, so where is the there it is. Nice. Worth it. Now to get the heck out of the dodge area. I'll take the new vehicle.
Zane cut its heart out, but it didn't die. The thing that wore Barbara's face kept crooning sweet nothings sugar-laced with poison. He put on the suit, untied the monster from the chair. The thing in his arms thrashed weakly, but he held fast. He stepped outside, off the pier, and into the dark water, a sinking pinprick of light descending toward a bottom that never came.
Yes, I'm almost done with this thing. Okay, I'll actually put the mic up because it's gonna get noisy. And the mic is on again. Okay, hopefully the stream still sounds good. Let me just give it a quick check. Check 1, 2. Okay, it actually sounds good. Alright. So for those now joining, I'm on the last chapter of Alan Wake. I'm on my way to Cauldron Lake to put an end to this period of time of terror. to fight the monster from the lake. Just a minute. To defeat the Stealer of Dreams. I heard... What is that? Oh! Cables broke. Now where is that? Oh. Okay, what did I do again? Oh, this. Yes, let me just check my bullets again. Everything is good. I feel as though I don't necessarily need to... Okay, that's, sorry. I forgot to check everything. I feel as though I don't necessarily need to stop anymore. I mean, I could probably get some more flares, who knows, but... Maybe I could just go straight. Go as far as I could go. Until I have to stop again. Because, I mean, no matter the section I end up in, I always end up with more than enough ammo. And of course, I always lose my weapons time and time again. So clearly, I didn't need as much as I had.
When I told Barry my plan back in the well-lit room, I'd acted as if I knew what I was doing. I didn't. I was operating on the shifting logic of a dream. I had to fight my way to the lake through the horrors of the night. I had to flick an old battered light switch imbued with childhood magic. I had to write a happy ending to a horror story. I had to save my wife from the dark prison she was being held in.
Oh, this is the first time I had to push something. Which is kind of interesting. Lights. We gonna have to fight.
I will never give her to you.
Oops. Wish I could get back some more ammo. Cause I damn near used it all. Fighting off these guys. Last place I'm going to check in, and I'm just going to keep moving forward with what I have, because I don't want to end up, like, I don't know, respawning some more of them, give myself more trouble. Alright, let me move forward. The thing about the soundtrack or the background music or whatever, the atmosphere music, is sometimes you hear a subtle sound that makes you think that maybe more enemies might be coming, so it kind of deters you from moving in certain directions, like going back too far, doing, you know, exploration. I think Alan needs to go on a fitness routine. He's really huffing and puffing.
The dark place I found myself in was unlike anything I could ever have imagined. It wasn't solid. It flowed. It was conceptual and subjective. For someone else, an artist in another field, it would have been very different. I could sense the story of the manuscript all around me, the words and ideas floating in the air, poised to become real.
Why is it looking like that? It's in the distance. Wait, is this the over the lake or? Oh! I was hearing it. Sheesh. It's like, I don't know, it's a weird, I was hearing the footsteps, but I think at the time I didn't think it was anything because it was not accompanied by the atmosphere change, the song change.
I can see near a peak in the distance. That's where Cauldron Lake was.
I wonder why these chests are here. Can you? I wonder if they represent something. It would be funny if this is the first time, like, you know, like I figure out that it's a secret. 1 second. Oh, you're supposed to actually go that way? Wait, so what's this over here? Oh, I thought this was leading to a road, but it's actually this way. I'm going in a cart, a minecart. This does not seem safe. Ah, here we go. Prepare for the ride of your life. Oh, it's much slower. It is going to pick up speed. It has to. I'm hearing things. Oh! But those birds were stupid. What the? Oh. Aww. Whoa. get some more birds. I have no idea why I'm pushing this. Okay, I guess that's the way it's supposed to go. But not before a little side track. Lovely. And if you heard that somewhere before, then that's exactly where I heard it. It's very catchy. Oh, this is an example of the atmosphere I was talking about. Signals that something is coming. Well, enemies. Usually two or three. Ah. So those black areas are like, I think you could see the high concentration of the darkness creature and its influence on the world. But one thing I'm grateful for is that they haven't like added any extra enemies that are way tougher. So far the enemies have, they are different strengths of enemies, but normally with games, the further into the game you get, you'd bring on more and more strong enemies. This is one of the strong enemies, but they're not that bad. I could just, you know. You know, like that. He could have killed me though, but. I have a feeling these things are gonna come alive and attack me. Look at those perfect destructive shapes. Okay, I'm getting tired of this. And since there's flare gun ammo, I'm gonna use it. Thank you. All right. Oh, somebody's helping me. Once it's not alive, you know, I'm good. Or possessed. Somebody's following me. Had me wasting ammo. Ooh. Or maybe it was not a friend who did that thing with the bombs. Maybe it was just an accident. Yeah, that boat is gonna come alive. It just looks perfect to rise up off the ground and attack. I think the good thing about clearing off these things is, in case you get engaged in a fight, you won't accidentally run into it. Somebody had to have lit that fire.
I needed to get the generator running.
If only the darkness knew what a generator was. And if they only knew if they destroyed it, I could not produce power. Good thing it only knows so much. Okay, the generator. Oh yes, and generators are always outside in very exposed places. Do note. Wow. What if I go near to it and it just runs up on the electric wire? Yep, it worked. Oh, okay, now I shouldn't play. Oh, come on. I was on such a good streak. Come on. I mean, it's not like I can't beat these things, it's just I want to use what I want to use, you know? Maybe I'm a conservationist. Maybe that's what I am. I like to conserve bullets. Conserve. But that's not what I wanted to use. Whoa, where did he come from? I just want to explore, man. I know it had some more glow sticks or whatever, flares. So I was trying to go back, but it's kind of annoying to know that even after clearing all the enemies, once you hear that sound, you know more enemies are coming. So it's like, it's not worth it.
After Zane had gone, I stood alone in the shifting dream that was the dark place. I had to find a way to the cabin. I'd written myself a way through this place in the manuscript. I followed the idea of a path. I had written myself across the ocean that blocked my way, and with that, there was a bridge to the island beyond. The idea of the cabin flickered in the underwater darkness. I willed the cabin to be real, and it was.
The amazing thing is when you kind of have a sense of what's going to happen, but you still have to actually go there yourself. And you're still entertained, you're still surprised by some things that happen. Hearing something coming after me.
Turn back now.
Ooh. Oh, wrong thing. Oh, switch up. Man, you are so mean. destroy the tornado. I mean, I wanna try something, but... Okay, I think they're telling me something here.
Light into its heart to hurt it.
Oh, just the heart? Oh. Am I not effective enough? It releases me to the right where I have the Alright, I don't think I need to wait here. Just have to make sure. Ooh, wrong. Since I had infinite ammo, I just decided to try and destroy it slowly from the outside, but I don't think I needed to. Going down. Is he willing the bridge, or is he going down then making a bridge?
out.
Last minute of doubt.
Shh, baby. You were having a bad dream.
Oh, nope. Don't trust you.
It was just another nightmare.
No.
The hell it is. Oh, yeah.
It wasn't a dream. Everything's fine. Turn the lights on. Turn the lights on!
Shh, baby. The power's out. There's no light. Come back to bed and I'll make you forget all about your fear.
Nope.
My fear? It's your fear. Why aren't you afraid? You're not Alice. Turn the lights on now. Where's the clicker? What did you do with it?
Alan? You're scaring me now. Go back to bed. Have you taken your pills? Do you want me to call Dr. Hartman? I read your manuscript. It's brilliant. Departure is your best work. You're a genius. I'm so proud of you. Come back to me. Stop worrying about it anymore. Come back to bed.
Ooh.
Come back to bed, Tom.
Hello, Thomas. Fancy seeing you here. What? That's... He's probably the... Every time you see him smile, that's Mr. Scratch. That's... Because I've seen that face he makes.
Should have never written back. You came back wrong. Your heart is filled with darkness.
Your husband refused to do as he was told. All he had to do was write.
So now the, wait, I wonder if he stays down there and Mr. What was his name? Clicker? Mr. Happy, whatever his name is, will be returning to the surface.
I could feel Alice's presence close by. I understood what I had to do now. I knew how to write the ending to Departure. There's light and there's darkness. Cause and effect. There's guilt and there's atonement. But the scales always need to balance. Everything has a price. That's where Zane had gone wrong.
So,
there's a long journey through the night back into the light.
So what, he cannot return or something? Is that the price
Oh, no.
He has to pay? Okay, so this is the rewritten story, I assume. See, this is time fast forwarding, I think. Then he'll be on in the car, maybe. Hey, oh, she's swimming back up. Wait, I mean, it could happen, and I probably won't mind it, but it would be nice to see everyone and everything, you know, like sort of a epilogue type thing, but are they going to roll credits here? So, Alan is trapped in the room. It looks like that's the end. But the guy, Zane, said they would meet the other person, you know, who looks like him, but it's like how and when and everything else. Yeah, I guess this is kind of like the epilogue thing I was referring to. You get to see all the people who survived because of his sacrifice. Well, she looks like she's the new lamp lady. Maybe. So maybe that's the same thing that happened. Well, that's the end of Alan Wake Remastered. Great game. This song, is it? Oh, I used this song for a music video from Guardians of the Galaxy on my YouTube channel. That's why the song is so familiar. Ground control to Major Tom. Fitting, quite fitting. And he even looks like an astronaut, Thomas Zane. To Major Tom. Take your protein pills and put your helmet on. Alright, so to avoid like copyright strikes and all those things, I have to end the stream. Well, not the stream, but the song. So I'm done. I didn't expect to finish so soon. I was thinking it was going to be like 3 hours, but I'm done, and I had no plan of what exactly to do next. So I don't know if I'll just relax and, you know, any stream and watch a movie or something. So yeah, the next thing I'm thinking to play is Control, but that could change if I so choose. But I hope it's been fun. I think I'll end the stream now. If I decide to come back on later, then if you're following me, you'll get a notification. So thanks for joining. Hope it was fun, and I'll catch you all next time. Great game, by the way.